In this video, we are going to cover pointers in Go. But before we dive in, let's start by reviewing what a variable is. A variable is a storage for a value. We assign a value to a variable and then pass it around or change it later. Let's take a simple example. We define a variable a and assign a number 1 to it. Then we define a variable b with a value of a, which is 1. Then we change the value of b to 5. When we print the values, we can see that b has a value of 5, but a remains unchanged. Now let's move to the pointers. A pointer value is the memory address of a variable. It points to the location where the value of a variable is stored. Knowing the address of some variable, we can change its value indirectly. To get the address of a variable, we use an ampersand operator. When we use asterisk operator, we retrieve a value stored by that address. That may sound confusing at first, but let's see it on an example. Let's take the address of a variable a and assign it to a new variable p. Here we put an ampersand operator in front of a variable to get its address. The p points to a variable a. It knows its address, but not the value itself. Now let's change the value stored by that address. Using asterisk p, we can access the value where the variable p points to. Now we are printing the value of our variable a and the value stored by the address of a. We can see that a now has a different value. We change it indirectly. Now let's check a variable types. A has a type int. The value stored by the address of a is also int. But the type of variable p is different. It's a pointer to int. The zero value of a pointer of any type is nil. That means the pointer doesn't point to any variable yet. Now, if we need to assign a value to a pointer, we need to take the address of some variable. We can try to assign a value to the p, but since p doesn't point to any address, the following assignment will fail. What we need to do instead is to create a variable and then assign its address to p. Sometimes that might be not very convenient, because when we want to change where the pointer points to, we need an extra variable. In that case, we can use the new function, which allows us to create an unnamed variable of some type. Assigning the result of a new function will be a pointer to that type, and its value will be a zero value of that type. Let's change our current example to use new function. Even though the variable is unnamed, it has an address. So now we can change the value stored by that address. As you can see, our example doesn't print the message anymore, because the p is not nil. Let's work through another example to see how we can use pointers to achieve different results. In this example, we have two functions. One function takes an integer variable, increases its value by 1, and returns a new variable. Another function takes an address of some variable, increases the result stored by that address, and returns nothing. We can also say that we are passing an argument by value to a first function. In case of a second function, we are passing it by reference. In the first part of our example, we call the first function to change the value of a variable. It returns the new result, but because we are not assigning a new value to a variable, it remains unchanged. In the second example, we explicitly assign a new value to a variable, so it is changing. The third part passes an address to a variable to the function. Since the function operates with address, its side effect is what it can change the value of the original variable. That's exactly what we see here. Two calls of a function increase p increases the initial value of a by 2. Using pointers might be confusing at first, but knowing how they work and how to use them can be a powerful tool.